Web components enable you to build a great website through the use of reusable components. But what does it take to build a web component? My name is Eiji, and today I'm going to give you an overview of template element. The idea of templating isn't a new thing. Starting from server-side, templating has been a widely used technique for assigning variables, conditional behaviors, and repeated contents inside HTML. On the browser side, similar attempts have been made by various libraries using JavaScript, such as handlebar.js, underscore.js, angular.js, to name a few. They all work well, but approaches taken by those libraries may have pitfalls. In this example, the template is actually a div tag, which is hidden with a bit of CSS. A downside of this approach is that the browser will fetch resources like this image element from inside the template, even if those resources haven't been used yet. It's a waste of resources and performance. Another technique involves storing the template content inside of a script tag. Downside of this approach is because this template will be converted into DOM elements using inner HTML. It could introduce a cross-site scripting vulnerability if an adequate sanity check is not performed. The template element will solve those problems. Template allows you to declare fragments of markup, which are parsed as HTML but go unused at runtime and can be instantiated later when you need them. Template element won't render its contents by itself, won't fetch any required resources, including scripts, styles, or images, and also won't execute scripts inside of itself. Currently, the template element is supported in Chrome, Firefox, and Opera. Safari is expected to support it in version 8. But you guys know that things change weekly, so check in on chromestatus.com. To detect availability of the template tag, check if HTML template element is available under window object. For unsupported browsers, you can use platform.js, a collection of web components polyfills made available as part of the Polymer library. This will automatically detect the availability of the template element and polyfill it if necessary. It is really simple to add your own template to HTML. Just wrap your template markup with template tag. This will make your markup inert, so it will no longer render on the page until you stamp it out. To stamp out a template, you'll need to write a bit of JavaScript. By using document import node, you can create a clone of the template content. Note that setting the second argument as true makes it a deep copy. Once you created the copy, you can just append it wherever you want. One thing you should note before moving forward is that the template itself is simply a container for markup. You might expect to have things like placeholders, repeaters, or conditionals, but they are not a part of template element standard. If you want to use those advanced features, I recommend you to use web components frameworks such as Polymer or Xtag. So this is the template element. To learn more about template element in detail, make sure to read the HTML5 Rocks article written by Eric Biderman. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode.